You're welcome to Open Heaven's Devotional Commentary, a guide to a close fellowship with God. I'm Salam Manager Haruna, your host. We are glad to have you. Hello, good morning. Thank you for joining us today again. Open Heavens is written by our Father and the Lord, Pastor E.A. Adeboye, General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. And this commentary is intended to bring insights to God's Word by the help of the Holy Spirit. Today's date is Sunday, the 8th day of August 2021, and our topic for today is Be Thankful. Let us pray. Our gracious Father, we are grateful to be before you one more time. We've come to be fed by you. We ask that as you send your word across to us today, cause that there'll be an understanding of your word. Help us not just to be hearers, but to be doers and partakers of this word in the name of Jesus. Let it become wisdom and instruction to us in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. You're welcome back. Our memory verse for today is from the book of Psalm chapter 103 verse 2. Psalm 103 verse 2 reads, Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Psalm 103 verse 2. And our scripture reading for today is from the book of Luke chapter 17 verse 11 to 19. Luke 17 verse 11 to 19 reads, And it came to pass, as he went to Jerusalem, that he passed through the midst of Samaria and Galilee. And as he entered into a certain village, there met him 10 men that were lepers, which stood afar off. And they lifted up their voices and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. And when he saw them, he said unto them, Go show yourselves unto the priests. And it came to pass that as they went, they were cleansed. And one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back and with a loud voice glorified God, and fell down on his face at his feet, giving him thanks, and he was a Samaritan. And Jesus answering said, Were there not 10 cleansed? But where are the 9? They are not found that return to give glory to God, save this stranger. And he said unto him, Arise, go thy way, thy faith had made thee whole. God bless his word in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. In our devotional today, we have our Father in the Lord tell us that one expectation of the Almighty God is the appreciation of his children for numerous blessings he bestows on them. It is unfortunate, however, that humans from generation to generation have been ungrateful. They forget the goodness of God soon after receiving his blessings and begin to speak against the lover of their souls. James chapter 1 verse 13 to 14 says, Let no man say when he is tempted, I am tempted of God. For God cannot be tempted with evil, neither tempted he any man. But every man is tempted when he is drawn away of his own lust and enticed. After the Lord Jesus healed 10 lepers, he expected them to return and say, Glory to God in the highest. To his surprise, however, only one of the 10 came and he asked, Were there not 10 cleansed? But where are the 9? They are not found that return to give glory to God, save this stranger. Ingratitude is an act of robbery against God. The greatest danger of ingratitude is the giving of the glory that belongs to God to someone or something else. This is practical idolatry, punishable for all eternity. In addition, it is dangerous not to be thankful because your joy cannot be full if you are not thankful. The only person we can consider as having fullness of joy among these 10 lepers is the one who returned to give glory to God. Jesus then crowned his healing by saying to him, Arise, go thy way, thy faith hath made thee whole. Luke 17 verse 19. We must note, however, that the first way to show gratitude to God is to accept his offer of salvation, which seems free but costs the life of the innocent Son of the living God. We must embrace his offer with every sense of gratitude. Indeed, our acceptance of the Lordship of Jesus Christ over our lives is the most profound form of gratitude we can ever express to God. The Lord bless you as you do so today in the mighty name of Jesus. If you have already submitted to his Lordship, begin to count your blessings and give him heartfelt thanks. God bless his word to us today in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Our topic for today still remains be thankful. And to continue with this, I'd like us to have in mind the picture of two children. Let's say two children of the same parents. The first is not always given to Thanksgiving. He is not thankful. As a matter of fact, he believes whatever is done for him is his right. He complains when things don't go his way and can never be found to say thank you. On the other hand, the other child always acknowledges even the minutest of things. He is always grateful for every kind gesture. I am sure by now you know which of the children is likely to receive more favor from the parents, consciously or unconsciously. Our attitude towards God as concerns thanksgiving is very important. There's a popular saying that if you are thankful, your tank would be full. It is also said that if you are not grateful, then you are a great fool. All of this just to connote the importance of thanksgiving. Thanksgiving is a key to accessing more from God. Of all the 10 lepers who were healed by our Lord Jesus, only one was made whole. And if you ask me, there's a big difference between being healed and being made whole. Taking a careful look at our scripture reading for today, the story of the 10 lepers, you'd see that our Lord Jesus actually expected the 10 of them to return. It is the same way he expects us to return to appreciate every of his work that we see in our lives. But many times what we do is we just shrug our shoulders and then we keep moving. Life continues. We believe after all he is God and he's our Father. It is his responsibility. The next time he sees us again is when we are in need. It needs not to be so. Our Father in the Lord states categorically in today's devotional that ingratitude is an act of robbery against God. The moment you deny him that gratitude, you are actually robbing him. What you are doing is you are sharing that glory with either someone or something else. We don't have to look too far to see the things that we need to even thank God for. As simple as we believe it is to take in air and breathe out. We have many in the hospitals paying huge sums of money just to keep alive. You can count on your fingertips 1,001 reasons to be thankful. Do not rob God of that gratitude. In 5 seconds, just say a word of gratitude to him now. Say, Father, we thank you for the gift of life, for the gift of your Son, for the gift of salvation. Be exalted, we return all thanks. Be glorified in Jesus' name. We are also made to understand in our devotional today that the first way to show gratitude to God is to accept his offer of salvation. Scripture tells us that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. He had us in mind and that was why he endured the cross. So the best way to say thank you is to accept his sacrifice. If you are yet to accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you have the opportunity again today. Say with me, Lord Jesus, I come before you today as a sinner. I believe you died for me and that you rose again. Have mercy on me today. Cleanse me of all unrighteousness and receive me as your own. I declare today I am born again in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. If you have said that prayer and meant it, I want to assure you that you are now born again. Please find a Bible-believing church and plant yourself there so that you may grow. We'd also bow our heads now and pray. Say, Father, I thank you for the salvation of my soul through Jesus Christ my Lord. Greater love had no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. Say, Father, help me to live by his teachings to the glory of your holy name in Jesus' name. Ask for the baptism of the Spirit of Thanksgiving. Our Father, we come with a heart of thanksgiving before you today. Thank you for your numerous and undeniable blessings upon our lives. We ask that from this day, we would never stop giving thanks in the name of Jesus. Help us also that in our lives, your sacrifice would never be in vain. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. In our Bible in 1 year reading plan for today, we read from the book of Job chapter 37 and chapter 38. Praise God. Thank you for joining us today. We are glad you are here. We believe you are blessed. If you'd love to speak to someone or to receive updates like this daily, please send a WhatsApp or Telegram message to +234 80 986 11226. You can do well also to share this with someone to be a blessing to them today. It is our prayer today that as we go forth, we would have all reasons to keep giving thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. Have a great day ahead and bye for now.
I believe you enjoyed today's devotional. We'd love to hear from you. Kindly leave a comment. You can connect with us on any of our social media handles attached. God bless you. Have a great day and see you tomorrow.